Hello friends, now we are going to see the unit number 3, functions of several variables, and the topic name is maxima and minima for two variables. So first let's have the outline of the PPT. So first we will start with the introduction and then how to go for about the working rule, and then we have few problems to be discussed and then we have conclusion. So let's start with the introduction. Definition: a function f of two variables is said to have a relative maximum or a minimum at a point a comma b if there is a disk centered at a comma b such that f of a comma b is greater than f of x comma y. This is for relative maximum, and the term which is given inside the bracket will go for relative minimum. That is, f of a comma b is less than or equal to f of x comma y for all points x comma y that lie inside the disk. A function is said to have an absolute maximum or a minimum at a comma b if f of a comma b is greater than or equal to f of x comma y, or f of a comma b is less than or equal to f of x comma y for all points x comma y that lie inside in the domain of f. So f as a relative absolute, the other name for relative will be absolute maximum or minimum at a comma b, then we say that f has a relative absolute extremum at a comma b. So let's have the definition of saddle point. So what is a saddle point? A critical point which is neither a maximum nor a minimum is called a saddle point. So a point which is neither a maximum nor a minimum is called as a saddle point. And now let's discuss the conditions for maxima and minimum. If f of x comma y has a maximum or a minimum value at a comma b, then its partial derivatives vanish. That is the first. What do you mean by fx? Fx is nothing but dou f upon dou x. That's the partial derivative of f of x comma y with respect to x. And next we find dou f upon dou y. So this f of x comma y is a function of x and y. So we differentiate this partially with respect to x and with partially with respect to y. That is the first step what we do in maximum minima. And we equate both of them to zero so that we get some points, and we name those points are called critical points. So based on this condition, we declare that whether the function is maximum or a minimum. So here the sufficient condition for f of x comma y to have a maximum value at a comma b. So what we do, we get the partial derivative a comma b equal to 0 and a comma b is equal to 0, and we find out the second derivative, which means that f double x of a comma b is equal to a or r, f x y of a comma b is equal to s or b, f double y of a comma b is equal to t or c, which means when I find the delta value r t minus s square, it should be greater than 0 for both maximum and minimum values, and when I see that a value is less than 0, then I call the point is called as a maximum point, and when it is greater than 0, then the point is said to be a minimum point. And when the delta value, that is r t minus s square, is less than 0, that is we are carrying a negative value, then it is called as an extremum point, which is called as a saddle point, which is neither a maximum nor a minimum. So what will happen? We have discussed the cases greater than 0 and less than 0. What will happen if it is equal to 0? The delta value is equal to 0, then the test is considered to be inconclusive, which means that we cannot give any conclusion for the points. So let's start up with the problems. So we have around two problems or three problems. So we have to stuff, first thing is find the maximum and minimum value of x square plus y square plus 6x plus 12. So what do I do? How do I start my problem? First, I will write what is given. Given f of x comma y is equal to x square plus y square plus 6x plus 12. So why do I write f of x comma y? Because in this particular second degree equation, I find that I have both x variable as well as y variable. So I name that particular equation as f of x comma y. Suppose if I have z also involved in this particular equation, Then I name that particular equation as f of x comma y comma z. So f of x comma y is equal to x square plus y square plus 6x plus 12. So what do I do with this? So first I have to find the partial derivative with respect to x and with respect to y, I told you. With respect to x means when I'm going to differentiate this x square, I'll be getting 2x. And when I differentiate this y square with respect to x, I'll be getting 0. And when I differentiate this 6x with respect to x, I'll be getting 6. What happens if I differentiate this 12 with respect to x or y? It is going to be 0 because it is a constant. So my answer is 2x plus 6. Next, we find dou f upon dou y, which means I'm going to differentiate this with respect to y. So when I differentiate this x square with respect to y, I'll be getting a 0 because there is no y there. Coming to the second term, that is y square. So when I differentiate y square partial with respect to y, I'll be getting 2y, and the rest of the terms will be 0 because there is no y inside. So after getting these two partial derivatives, I will equate them to 0, so that what point I told you, these points are called as critical points or stationary points, whatever it is. So I'll be equating 2x plus 6 is equal to 0, which implies x is equal to minus 3. And dou f by dou y is equal to 0, which implies y is equal to 0. And the stationary point is minus 3, 0. There is only one point we are getting it, so that point will be called as minus 3, 0. And at the side by side, I will go and find out my second derivative, which is r, s, and t. R is 2 times differentiation with respect to x, and t is 2 times differentiation with respect to y, and s is makes it partial derivative. So which is going to be, so if I am going to differentiate dou f by dou x, so now we have the second partial derivative with respect to x is equal to 2, and second partial derivative with respect to y is equal to 2. And makes it partial derivative, that is taking up this dou f by dou x, differentiating this with respect to y, I'll be getting it as 0. Why? Because there is no y term here. So I have found out r, s, and t. And as I told you, the stationary point is minus 3, 0. And now we move further. We construct a table. There is only one point, minus 3, 0. And we, as I told you, r, s, and t, which is r is equal to f double x, s is equal to f x y, and t is equal to f y y. And you know the values what we got earlier was 2, 0, 2. And r and t minus s square. So 2 into 2 will give you 4 minus 0, which is 4. And what will happen with this point minus 3, 0? What I'm going to do with this, I'm going to substitute wherever x comes, I will substitute as minus 3. Wherever y comes, I will substitute as 0. So there, since there is no variables here, x and y, so I'm going to directly take those values and I'm going to discuss. So what happens to the delta value? 4 is greater than 0, which means that delta value is positive. So for a point to be maximum or a minimum, the delta value should be strictly positive. So since this is positive, so this point will be either maximum or a minimum. So how to fix that? We have to go for r and we have to see that whether r is positive or negative. So if r is also positive, then the point will be declared as minimum. Suppose if r is negative, then the point will be told as maximum. So the minimum value of the function will be taking this particular point and going back and substituting inside the function, the given function f of x comma y. So wherever x comes, I will substitute as minus 3, and wherever y comes, I will substitute as 0. So minus 3d whole square will be 9. This term will be 0, and this will be minus 18 plus 12. So your answer will be 3. So problem number 2, commute f of x comma y is equal to x cube plus y cube minus 12x minus 3y plus 20 for its extreme values. So extreme values are nothing but we got to check whether the points are maximum or minimum or a saddle point or whatever it is. So let's start up with f of x comma y. We write down the given function. As I told you earlier, we are going to name this as f of x comma y because we have x and y variables involved in the particular equation. So first step will be partially differentiating with respect to x and with respect to y. Partially differentiating this equation with respect to x will be, this term when I differentiate, it's going to be 3x square. This term will be 0. And when I differentiate this minus 12x, I'll be getting minus 12. Same way, fy. This term will be 0. And when I differentiate this, it's going to be 3y square. And this term will be 0. And when I'm going to differentiate minus 3y, I'll be getting minus 3. So then, immediately, I'll find out the second derivative with respect to double x, xy, and fyy, which means r, s, and t. So, 3x square, when I differentiate, I'll be getting 6x. And when I differentiate fy, I'll be getting 6y. Now, what do? To calculate the critical point, I have to equate the first derivative with respect to x and with respect to y equal to 0. So, what is your first derivative and the first derivative of x and y? We see that 3x square minus 12 and 3y square minus 3. So, equating those to 0, I'll be getting the points 2, 1, 2, minus 1, minus 2, 1, minus 2, minus 1. So, tabulating these 4 points as we did earlier. So, here we have 6x. So, substitute in place of x, I have substituting 2. I'll be getting 12. In the same way, for each and every point, I'll be calculating this r, s, and t throughout, and I'll tabulate it in a table. And finally, when I go for my conclusion, I see that where is the delta value greater than 0? So I find here and this one, that is the point 2, 1, and under the point minus 2, minus 1, I see that the delta value is greater than 0. So when I fix it as delta greater than 0, that out of these 2 points, one point will be maximum and the other will be minimum. To fix that up, I have to go for r, and I find r is greater than 0 here, whereas r is less than 0 here. So whenever is r is greater than 0 and delta greater than 0, then the point will be minimum, and when r is less than 0, then the point is said to be maximum. Now after declaring this maximum and minimum values, I will go back and substitute inside the function to get the minimum value of the function and the maximum value of the function. So what had happened to the rest of the 2 points? I saw that the delta value is less than 0 in both the cases. Here minus 72 is less than 0, and here minus 72, sorry, there's an error, minus 72 is less than 0. So whenever delta values are less than 0, then these 2 points will be called as saddle points. So now let's start up with the assignment problems. So I have given 2 assignment problems. So you have to find out the maximum and minimum, or in other words, it is called as extremum. Maximum and minimum values of f of x, y, which is equal to x square minus xy plus y square minus 2x plus y. So how do I start up with? You have to differentiate this with respect to x first, with respect to y, and equate them to 0. Get the points, and those points are called as stationary points. After getting the stationary points, tabulate it in a table and find out r, s, and t. Substitute those points in that r, s, and t. Again, you tabulate it as we did in the previous problem, and then give your conclusions. Whenever you have delta value greater than 0, the point would be either maximum or minimum point. Whenever the delta value is less than 0, the point will be called as a saddle point. And suppose when the determinant delta value is equal to 0, then the point is said to be, test is said to be inconclusive. So we start up with the second problem. A flat circular plate is heated so that the temperature at any point x, y is u of x, y is equal to x square plus 2y square minus x. Find the coldest point on the plate. So they have clearly told you what is the requirement. Say they are asking the coldest point on the plate. So coldest point on the plate refers to minimum point. So what do you do? This is u. You have to differentiate this u with respect to x and with respect to y, and you get one point. And that point will be called as the minimum point, because they are asking the requirement of coldest point. So after getting your minimum point, you substitute that inside the function and you get the coldest value on the plate. Thank you so much.